Are you ever curious about what happens after you throw out a piece of trash? Well, today we get to go behind the scenes of a landfill and a recycling center to see what happens after you put that piece of trash in a trash can. It involves a ton of math. Let's get into it.
Doodly doodle, doodly doodle, doodly doodles and digits. Area, symmetry, fractions too, it's all here for you.
What is a landfill? A landfill is a large outdoor site where waste is buried in layers of earth.
Hi, I'm Muhammad Ali. I'm the engineering manager for WM. Landfills are spread out. It varies from 100 acres or 50 acres to hundreds of acres. If you're in a flat area, you could see a big mound as you drive around, you know, a grassy mound.
So I'm Eric Palmer. I'm the area disposal manager. I get to hang out at a lot of landfills.
I'm Karen Factor. I'm the area collection manager for WM and the Buckeye Market Area in Central Ohio.
What does a typical day look like in your career?
You think about the truck behind me, we pick up maybe 1,000 homes a day. You see that arm moving and picking up those carts.
The day in the life of our landfill starts pretty early. Around 5 o'clock in the morning, we have a group of folks that are here and they operate the heavy equipment. At some point in the day, a second crew comes in, typically that's around 8 a.m, and they start mining dirt out of the ground. So there's a big excavator that's filling really big trucks. They're delivering dirt to the working phase so that we can make sure that we cover the waste every single night. Then you have a group of folks like myself and Ali who come in. We monitor the performance of the landfill. Then at the end of the day, our customers leave. Our frontline team begins to cover and finish up covering up everything. We have gas techs that are out there monitoring the gas and making sure we're getting all the gas we can to the plant.
How do you use math?
You know, it probably starts with the customer. When we're deciding to take and receive their waste materials, we have to know how much they're gonna send us. We spend a lot of time in the operations focused on perimeter and area and square footage, so we know exactly how much to place in certain areas.
Our collection vehicles are all equipped with computers, and those computers measure and track from the hours that our drivers and employees work to the number of homes that they service every day to the actual weight of the material that they pick up. That truck can hold up to 10 tons of material. We measure how many pounds per home, so that information helps us determine how many trucks we need on the street on a daily basis. Maybe you have 10 routes a day. So that's 10,000 homes a day.
What does structure have to do with a landfill?
I call landfill is like a mega structure. It has a foundation. When we design a landfill, it has a certain shape, you know, whether it could be a rectangle shape. As you place the waste and compact and cover it, then you got to ensure that it has stability that goes with that.
So what does happen after you throw out a piece of trash?
The journey of waste is something that's been documented. It's kind of interesting. Materials that eventually reach this spot could be 80 miles away. So you eat your apple and you place your core in the waste can. That can then traverses down to the end of the street, or goes down to the end of the street at your house, and it gets picked up on a truck. And that truck drives onto a scale and we weigh that truck. And then it's taken up to the top of the hill where we place it into the waste mass. So we bring it in with all the other waste. Then what happens is we close that up at the end of the day by putting dirt on top of it and sealing it in there. And there's these tiny little bugs that go in and start eating stuff. And those bugs create methane gas. And then we take the gas and we pipe it over, in some cases, to a power plant.
We use the landfill gas in different variety of ways, generating electricity by running turbines, applying vacuum through drilling wells to the waste mass, and collecting the gas.
Where we turn it into electricity to power your homes. In other cases, we pipe it into a gas line that actually is taken to your house and it heats your house.
The objects that you put in a recycling bin will go to a recycling center. A recycling center also uses a lot of math. Some of the math that a recycling center uses are figuring out the weight of items coming in, how much they're recycling, the data of how efficient they are, and also how many tons per hour that they are recycling. This recycling center actually can recycle up to 420 tons per day. That is a lot of recycling. When you recycle, you're giving your trash a new life. Recycled items are turned into all sorts of things, such as cans, paper, new bottles, toys, and even park benches. It's really incredible what recycling can do. The waste trucks pick up 10,000 homes in a day in one area. How many homes' trash will they pick up after 7 days? Trash. I did 7 times 10,000 homes, and that equals 70,000. 70,000 homes trash. Did you get it correct?
A lot of people to this date don't know what we do. I mean, a lot of people think, you know, we are a garbage company. People don't have a good understanding of how that is managed. It's a lot of science that gets involved. It's a lot of technology that's involved in it.
People are really surprised to learn how inside us capturing that waste, what we're doing to create renewable energy. When they finally understand what a modern landfill actually is, they're a little bit flabbergasted, and certainly they're a lot more confident in what we do every day. That's for sure.
I think the best advice I give to everyone is to do what you enjoy doing. If you like math, follow that where your calling is, and work with people that enjoy math and do the things that you love to do.
I'm an engineering manager at WM.
I'm an area disposal manager, and that's how this is math. That's how it's math. I'm an area disposal manager, and I can't say that last line. I'm an area disposal manager, and that's how it's math.
Want more information about how math is used in the real world? Make sure you check out our website, www.doodleslearning.com. Bye!